Access ships with many built-in functions that you can use to modify the data that's stored in your data tables. Occasionally, however, these won't be enough to calculate exactly what you need, or perhaps you want to save a complex calculation to use over and over again. In these cases, you'll want to create your own custom functions in Visual Basic. We can start that process by coming up to the Create tab and coming over to the Macros and Code section on the far right and clicking on Module. That'll open up a brand new program called Microsoft Visual Basic for Applications, and this is where we get the acronym VBA. I want to make sure that we have three different windows open here on our screen. We've got the Project Explorer up here in the upper left, the Properties window on the lower left, and the Immediate window across the bottom. If you're missing any of these windows, just come up here to View, and you can toggle them on with the Immediate window option, Project Explorer, or Properties window. In the Properties window, I'm going to change the name of our module from the default name to My Functions. You'll see that change gets made up here in the Project Explorer and in the title bar of the window that's currently open here. In this window is where we're going to type in the different functions that we want to create. I'll come down to the line below Option Compare Database, and we'll type in the keywords public function. Public means that this function is going to be available outside of the code module, so we can use it in queries and forms, for example. The function that I want to create is going to calculate an age when we give it a date of birth. I'll name it simply age and open a parenthesis. Inside of the parentheses, we're going to type in the different arguments or the data that we're going to pass in to the calculation. So in order to calculate an age, we need a date of birth. I'll just call it DOB for short. Then Access needs to know what type of data to expect. Now obviously date of birth is going to be a date data type, so I'll type in as date. We'll finish the public function declaration with a closing parenthesis and press enter to come down to the next line. When I do so, Visual Basic adds in the end function line down below. In between these two lines is where we're going to type in the different steps to calculate an age given a date of birth. We'll start that process by typing in age equals. Now there's lots of different ways to calculate an age given a date of birth. One way is to take today's date and subtract the date of birth, and that'll give us the number of days that have elapsed between the two. In order to get today's date, I'll use one of Access's built-in functions that's simply called date. That'll give us today's date, and we'll simply subtract DOB. This is the date that we pass in when we run this function. Now I want to make sure that this calculation happens first, so I'm going to wrap that in parentheses. Then we'll come to the end, and I'll divide the whole thing by 365.25. This is the average number of days in a year. At this point, the function is going to return a very precise fraction of a year, and I actually want to just drop off the remainder and return the whole number of years. So we're going to wrap this whole thing here in another function. I'll type a parenthesis at the very end. We'll come back to the beginning, I'll type in another parenthesis, and this function is going to be called int. This will essentially just return the whole number of years that have elapsed without any extra days. So there's our entire calculation. Let's come down here to the immediate window and we'll test it out. We'll do that by typing in a question mark, the name of the function, age. I'll open a parenthesis and we'll give it a date. Remember in Access, we use the date delimiters of the pound symbols around our dates. So I'll type in a pound and then 10/28/1955. We'll finish it with another pound symbol and a closing parenthesis. This is the birth date for Microsoft co-founder Bill Gates. And when I press enter, we'll see that at the time of the recording, that he is 62 years old. So we can see our age function is working. Let's go ahead and create another public function. I'll come back up here into my window. I'll press enter to come down to another empty line, and we'll start the process again with public function. This function is going to take in two arguments, the first name and the last name of a person, and it's going to return a formatted string where we have last name, comma, first initial. I'll name this function formatted name. Open a parenthesis, and the first argument is first name, and we'll be passing that in as a string character type. I'll type in a comma, and I can type in the second argument, which is last name, and that'll also be a string data type. I'll type in a closing parenthesis, and this time we want to specify that we want this returned as a string, so I'll type in as string one more time. We'll come down to the next line and type in the calculation here, so formatted name is equal to, and it's simply going to return just the last name. And then we'll concatenate that or join that to the text string. So I'll type in an ampersand, a double quote. We're going to join that to a comma and then a space. I'll type in another double quote and another ampersand. We're going to join that string to a left function. Open a parenthesis. The left function will process the first name. And I'll type in a comma and a one. We'll finish that with a closing parenthesis. Another ampersand, a double quote, a period, and a double quote. Essentially what we're doing here is building a string that'll take the full last name, join that to a comma and a space, join that to the first initial of the first name, and join that to a period. Let's come down to the immediate window again, and I'll click my mouse to insert the cursor, and we'll type in formatted name. Open a parenthesis. This prompts me for the first name as a string, and remember we need to type that in double quotes. I'll type in Bill. I'll type in a comma, and then the last name as a string, again in double quotes, Gates. I'll type in the closing double quote and a closing parenthesis, and press Enter. And I'm getting a compile error here. That's actually because I forgot the question mark at the very beginning. So go ahead and type that question mark in, run it again, and it returns it as expected, Gates, comma B. Let's go ahead and save our code module now. I'll press the disk icon here on the toolbar. And it's going to prompt me to save the module name my function, and I'll just simply say OK. So that's a quick introduction on how you can begin to create custom functions in Visual Basic.